showers in the forecast tomorrow, but guess what? It works perfectly with a bald head, right?
Hey, it does, and we're not going to let it rain on our parade because we are in the fight for childhood cancer. We are working for research and also to ultimately come up with the cure. And we got a studio full of people. This is how we do it on News 3 today. So you know what? We're going to get to shaving heads. All right, here we go. We're talking about St. Baldrick's, but let's get it going right now before we get into the interview. We have Rosa, we have Kimber that are going to be shaving the heads of Brian and Jen. Thank you for being such wonderful volunteers this morning. So you're okay, you're going bald.
Right.
All right, you're doing it on live TV.
Right.
All right, here we go. Ready, set, let's get it going. Thank you guys. So Rosie and Kimber are gonna be helping us out with that. But we also have a couple of friends with us that are gonna be talking about the big event. We're so excited. Claire, you have an awesome story to share. You were first diagnosed with cancer at 10 years old. You've been in remission for 13 years and you're getting in on this effort as well. And our friend James, you're always in on all the
fun. Welcome back. We're braving the shave. You're number 10.
I love it. Wonderful. It's good to have you with us as well. So Claire, talk with us a little bit about why it's so important for you to continue supporting this cause.
Well, as a survivor, I think the most important thing is you want to see people not going through the same thing you went through and to bettering everybody. And for me to kind of represent maybe for kids who are my age, seeing that when my family was shaving their head and the whole team and seeing that somebody like me, a survivor, was doing it, I hope that'll give them some sort of solace and like know they're not alone and everything's gonna be okay eventually.
Absolutely, and you're living proof of that. She is standing before you today because of all the support from organizations like St. Baldrick stepping up and, you know, really making a difference when it comes to the fight against childhood cancer. And James, you are always in on the fun. So let's tell people where they need to be and all the fun stuff that's gonna be happening.
Absolutely. So tomorrow, of course, is up here at McMullen's. The bar is gonna be packed. It's gonna be amazing. Us at New York are really excited and so grateful to the McMullen's for including New York. This is our 10th annual at New York down on the Brooklyn Bridge.
So cool.
Over 600,000 raised last year in our event alone.
Awesome.
New York was the largest event in the history of,
of the
event, and now we're gonna try and break that record this year with everybody's help.
I love it. New York on the Strip always playing a big role in all of this. They know how to bring out the crowds, that's for sure. And we're gonna have a lot of fun at McMullen's too. The cross streets, so people know where they need to be for McMullen's. Cross streets, Dana?
The Orleans.
Yes, right across from the Orleans.
Okay,
absolutely.
Here we go.
You
it's
can't
on
miss.
Trop.
Yeah,
okay.
Just follow the crowds tomorrow. It's going to be
okay,
wild.
Okay, just follow
there.
The crowds.
It's on
trop,
right next to the Orleans.
Okay,
it's
there
a great
we go.
Pub, by the way. If you've never been there, you got to go just to check out the
Brewski. I know we pass by it all the time.
Right.
So, wanted to make sure we kind of get the cross streets for people. Okay, oh, look. We're doing some good stuff when it comes to shaving the heads here. Okay, it looks like we're getting close to having a wrap, but I sure wish we could get all of this so you could see what they look like with their bald heads. We'll have to take some pictures and put it on social media, or maybe we'll just maybe show it as we go into commercial break. Maybe we could do that.
We'll show them in the next segment.
Okay,
will. And you have to get ready to tease the CW, but we're also talking about Jimmy Fallon. He was having a little fun.